On my way back from the beach today, I was thinking about fear and how much of fear is it's amplified and made worse than it really is because of imaginative abilities. For me, the way that I feel fear, I'm now aware that in the premeditative state that I'm in before engaging in the thing that I think I'm afraid of, it's a different state of being because imagination is allowed to roam free. And just like imagination can be the source of dreams, it can become nightmarish as well. I feel like a lot of fears that we actually have are imagination-based, and they're just a sign of inexperience. What the fuck are those noises? This random music always plays regardless of the city I'm in, like at certain times during the day. I don't know if it's like an alarm or something, but also, something I'm noticing is that a lot of the times, the things that I'm afraid of, like, I get into a state of like, okay, I'm gonna overcome this fear because, yeah, I'm just gonna overcome it. So I go and try to do the thing that I think that. I go and I do the thing that I think that I'm afraid of. I hope this doesn't fuck up the quality of the audio. I do the thing that I think that I'm afraid of, only to find that I end up having a different experience anyway. It doesn't even manifest in the way that I thought that it would. It's like by trying to control our fears, we then take steps to overcome them, but we're trying to recreate our fear when the way that it was happening mentally was worse than it was ever gonna be. And I find that a lot of the times, fears only happen in the imagination realm because they can't manifest in the physical realm. Sometimes it turns out that the things that I'm afraid of and how real my imagination is because I'm aware that it's a realm unto itself. When I take certain actions and go do the thing that I'm afraid of, and I have experiences that end up leading me down different paths anyway, I have totally different, unexpected experiences. It's kind of like the fear was a catalyst. The fear was like some kind of illusionary drug that wears off, that propels me to go do things that, maybe I wouldn't have ever been inclined to do anyway. So it gives me a bit of insight on which fears that I choose to act on now, and which ones that I can just let stay in the imagination realm. Or, imagination realm is a term, that's not what it really is. It's a different realm. So it seems like feelings in themselves, passion, motivation, having visions and ideals of things that I'd like to become or things that I want, so I go and pursue it, or things that I'm afraid of, so implicitly I'm drawn into it. They lead me down different experiences, and I realize that within themselves, the water energy and the fire energy, they're up there. They're not, they're different planes. And I want to talk about a very dense fear, a fear of death. I'm not going to use the term we, because I know that there are spirits who see past this. A fear that a spirit could have of death. Sometimes I feel like we focus on the blatant deaths that, for some reason, they're more obvious, like our own physical death, or the death of someone that we love. Do we not realize that things that we think are us, they die all the time, and we don't really have any recollection of them, like, as we get older? Certain streams of consciousness die. As we get older, our skin cells fall off. We don't remember them. And so it seems that death itself is a process of shedding and a process of transformation and then rebirth. Here's something about a rebirth process. I feel like things are only very painful when we're clinging onto something that's trying to transform. Because if we're clinging onto it, we're not gonna control it. It's gonna mutate and distort us, and we're gonna start transforming in ways that perhaps we're not supposed to transform yet because we're clinging. So I feel like a fear of death, a fear of pain, comes from misunderstanding the nature of it. When we are, when we think that we're comfortable, when we think that we're secure, the notion of shit flipping, the notion of things changing, can seem scary because we're misunderstanding it. It's kind of like when you're afraid to do something that you've never done, the only thing you can really do is, like, get ready to do it and come up with a bunch of imaginations and ways that you think it will go. But when you're actually doing the thing, you're in a different state. And when you're done with it, perhaps some of those imaginary fears, they just become memory. Of just like, oh, I remember when I was scared of that. But now, you yourself are different. And maybe you don't realize how many parts of you died off in the process that you weren't aware of because you were engaged in doing whatever you were doing. Oftentimes, when we feel ready to do something, just that state of being ready takes away all of the stuff that we, how we thought things were going to be when we were still too unripe and too green. In my time traveling so far, this is the longest I've ever traveled, and it's not just travel to me, it's just where I am. It's what's going on. A lot of things have died off. I've shed a lot of things, and I'm realizing now, usually fear itself is mostly in my head and in the body. I've had situations where I've had no money because I didn't get paid for a few days. There was a gap. I've had times I didn't know where I would be until, like, a few days before going. I go and explore all these new places more or less by myself. And, dress much differently as well. I don't feel the need to be so covered up. Unless, like, I'm trying to avoid the sun. I notice that in some ways, I'm not traveling by myself. I throw away a lot of the labels and imaginations that come along with the idea of traveling solo. And more or less, I'm always around people, and I realize that I'm always in a space that is composed of things that are bigger than me, and anytime I'm in an environment, it's not me and then the environment, unless I want to be defensive for some reason. It's more so I'm a being that's having an interactive experience with the environment that I'm in. And since it's an interactive experience, there's exchange on both ends. For example, go into the beach. An interaction of the sun producing a reaction in me to get sunburned. Something about this realm is that I'm an independent spirit that's in an interactive realm. Also,